anger and aggression can often take on surreal qualities. I for instance, I once had a surreal tantrum, if you can imagine that. No need to, I'm about to explain what happened. Two, was it two? Could have been three. It's not important. I got this gig, which was to provide the voiceover on a computer game. Now, I thought that was really cool, okay? I was really excited about the idea of being a voice in a computer game. I mean, it didn't actually turn out to be a particularly cool computer game. It wasn't sort of like Vice City or EA Cricket, which is completely sewn up by the Test Match Special Boys. But nonetheless, it wasn't as cool as that. It was a game based about fishing. And it was aimed at children between the age of 2 and 5. Nonetheless, I thought, well, that'd still be pretty cool to have be a voice in a computer game. That'll be great. So I went to the booth and the sound studio. There's a list of phrases on a bit of paper. It doesn't really make any sense at the time, but you just read them into the microphone. And they go, we'll send you the game when it's finished. So 2 months later, I got the game. And it was in the... living in Toll Cross with my brother. And I was like, right, I'm going to try out the game, Ed. I'm going to try out the game. So I go into the little TV and gaming room we had. And it was a system, I don't know if it succeeded, actually. It was called Bubble. And what you do was, you played computer games using a DVD machine. So you pop that in the DVD, and then it comes up on the telly, obviously, and you use the DVD remote control as the controller for the game. Now, I started to play this. Now, my problem is, you see, I really like computer games, I have to say, but I'm not actually very good at them, okay? It takes me a long time to sort of get used to them, regardless, it would seem, of the age group they originally aimed at. I was trying to play this game, and I was, to be honest, not very good at it, and I was starting to get a little bit frustrated. And then I started realising I was getting very, 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 very frustrated indeed, because it turns out there is nothing more annoying than attempting to play a computer game and failing at it than having your own voice telling you what it is that you're doing wrong. It really is an incredibly annoying. I'm playing the game and I'm trying to catch a fish. Nothing's happened. I hear my own voice going, you need to press select when the fish swims. I'm pressing select, nothing's happening. You need to press select at the moment. I am pressing select, nothing's happening. Player one, you have caught no fish. I was pressing select all the bloody... My brother came in, thought I was having some sort of schizophrenic breakdown. What on earth's the matter with you? I said, well, I'm patronising for a start. It just seemed very unfair. I